everyone, welcome back to my channel. And in today's video, we are going to learn about estimation of working capital requirements in the subject of managerial economics and financial analysis. In the previous video, we learned about what is working capital, what are its subcategories again, and what do you mean by current assets, current liabilities, and all those things, right? Now we will see how do you estimation of working capital requirements. We'll be doing that in a separate chart kind of thing. So before explaining that, I will tell you why we have to do this. It is used to find out how much capital a company should have to meet the current liabilities. It is very simple definition. I need not explain you it again, but still, current liabilities are those things which we have to pay every month, like utility bills, like our rents and all. They are the expenses that a company will have every month or every year, right? So in order to meet this current liabilities, like utilities and rent and all those things, in order to meet these current liabilities, how much capital a company should have, or how much capital an industry should have. Okay, to find out that, we have to do this estimation of working capital requirements. Okay, we will be doing it on a paper, because here if I do it on this, we'll have to erase it all the time. If we erase and all, we will not be understanding the previous things and all. So we will be doing it on the paper. I will be explaining it to you on the paper. It is very simple. Do not get confused, do not get tense, do not get bored. So now let us get into the estimation. If you can see here, it is estimation of working capital requirements. Okay, we are going to estimate the working capital requirements, and we are having three columns: particulars, amount, and amount. This is the inner, and this is the outer one. Okay, this is inner one and this is the outer one. So in this we have some but in particulars we have some requirements and all the calculations we will be seeing now. Okay, and the first one is, and we have two parts, actually we have not two parts, we have total of five parts, in which two parts are very important to be discussed, and the remaining three parts we can get from these two parts. Okay, so the first one is current assets. We all know about current assets. I have been telling so many times in the previous videos. So current assets are nothing but what a company is having now. At present, what the company is owning, its capital or whatever it is. At present, what company is owning, at present, what a company is holding. So it is at present what a company is having is called as current asset. Okay. And again, in current assets, we have some divisions. We have some subcategories. The first one is stock in trade, or they are also called as inventories. Inventories are nothing but your transport, your raw materials, all these things will come under this stock in trade or inventories. Okay, stock in trade or inventories. And again, in this we have some subcategories. The first one is raw material. Raw material is nothing but, simply we can say that, unprocessed things that we purchase, and we will be using this unprocessed things in manufacturing or in producing some good. Okay, they are called as raw material. For raw material, we have taken some amount. And next is work in process. Work in process is nothing but raw material which is being processed, which is under process, is called as work in process. Okay, and this also we are taking some amount. And after that, it is finished goods. Finished goods are nothing but whose production is completed, whose manufacturing is completed, and which are ready to deploy. That means which are ready to be sold out. Okay. So in stock in trade, we have three. The first one is raw material, which is a very first stage, unprocessed things. And work in process, they are also called as semi-finished goods, you can see them. That means which are in process. And finished goods are those goods whose production, whose processing is completed. Okay, now the second category in current assets is debtors. Debtors are those people who, they are actually the customers. Okay, the customers who purchase the stock, who purchase the products from your company, but they did not give you the money yet. They will be paying it later. Right, they are called as the debtors. Okay, the customers who purchased the stock but they did not yet pay the bill. Okay, and the third one is prepaid, and this is also having some amount. And next is prepaid expenses. So prepaid expenses are the expenses which you will be paying prior to your business. Prior to your business is nothing but before the start of your business, or at the start of your business itself you will be paying some bills, you will be paying some money, right? They are called as the prepaid expenses. The word pre itself says first, before only it is being paid, right? It is also having some amount. The next is cash and bank balance. Cash and bank balance are of course current assets, right? They are the things which we have now. Cash available in the company at present, and what is the bank balance of the company at present. So these will also, so these are the things that come under current assets: stock in trade, debtors, prepaid expenses, cash and bank balance. These are the things which will come under current assets. Okay, all these will be adding up and you will be getting a total. Okay, and that is called as the total of part A, right? Sum of all the current assets is called as total of part A, and it is denoted here. Okay, now we are done with current assets, right? Now we will be moving on to the current liabilities. What are the current liabilities and how do we estimate them? I mean, what are the current liabilities that we consider into our estimation? Let us see now. Okay, moving to the current liabilities part. In current liabilities, we have two things. The first one is creditors and the second is delay in payment of expenses. You know what are current liabilities, right? Current liabilities are the things or are the payments that you have to do every month, that you have to do every year, right? So they are the, I mean, the expenses that a company will have to bear will come under current liabilities, right? So in that, the first one is creditors. Creditors are the people from whom we purchase in the sense the company, the industry will purchase the raw material from this creditors. They will purchase the raw material, but still they will pay the amount later. Okay, they purchase the material, but the amount is not paid at that time only. They will be paying the amount later. They will be giving the money later. Like sometimes in some like we first, if at all we forgot to take the money, or if at all some online payment is not working in the shop, or we are not having money, what do we do at that time? We will say, okay, I will give you money later, right? So in the same way, you will, they, the company will be purchasing the raw material, but still they will not give the money, right? So that is, they are called creditors. And next, delay and payment of expenses. Delay and payment of expenses is nothing but all the expenses like paying wages, paying salaries, maintenance cost. All those costs will come under this delay in payment of expenses. Okay, so they will also have some amount, right? And they will also be added up, and the total is called as total of part B, which is called as the sum of all the current liabilities. Okay, sum of all the current liabilities is denoted by B, total of B, and that is equal to some amount, right? Now, and here this amount is equal to sum of all these things, and here this amount is equal to sum of these two things. Okay, that is clear, right? Now, after getting after calculating current assets and current liabilities, the third step is we have to calculate the net working capital. Okay, here I did not give space, I forgot to give the space, but it will have space here. Net working capital. Okay, we already learned in the classification, in the types of capital video, that there are two types of capital: gross working capital and net working capital. And net working capital is equal to current assets minus current liabilities, right? So we will be calculating the net working capital by subtracting current liabilities from current assets. What is the total current assets that we got? A, right? So A minus the total current liabilities we got was B. So A minus B will give you some amount, right? This is the total net working capital. Now, the fourth category we have is contingency expenses. This contingency expenses are nothing but emergency expenses. If at all any emergency situation happens, like any fire accident or any thing like road accident to the vehicle in which we are taking the goods and all, if at all any situations of those kind happens, then we have to have some money in order to bear those expenses, right? They are called as the contingency expenses. And if you can see, we have added this contingency expenses to the net working capital. See, contingency expenses, usually companies will be calculating contingency expenses as a percentage of net working capital. That means, suppose if the net working capital is 100 rupees and the contingency percentage that we kept for our company was 10%. So what is 10% of 100? It is 10, right? So 10 rupees will be the contingency expenses. That means some percentage of net working capital they will be calculating and they will be allotting that money to the contingency expenses in order to bear any kind of expenses in case of emergency. Okay, that is about contingency expenses. Now, by adding all these things which are in this outer column, we will be getting the total working capital requirement. Okay, that's all. Very simple. Estimation of working capital requirements is very simple. You may be getting nervous by looking at all these names, X and all these things, but no, they are very easy, right? I think you guys are clear. We have 5 columns in this. The first one is current assets. You know what is current assets. And the second one is current liabilities. You know about them also. The third is net working capital, which is column A, I mean part A minus part B. And the part D is contingency expenses, which is a percentage of net working capital, that is part C. And part E, the fifth part, is total working capital requirement you will be getting by adding all these things. Okay, that's all for this video, guys. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, do subscribe and do not forget to share it with your friends. Hit the bell icon so that you will be receiving the notifications whenever I will post a video. And if you understood clearly whatever I've explained in this video, hit the like button and feel free to give your suggestions and comments in the comment box. If you want me to include any other subjects or any other topics, let me know. I will do it for you if I can, and I will try to do as possible, with my complete efforts I will try to do them. And that's all for this video, guys. In the next video we'll be coming up with another topic. Thank you for watching the video, guys.